Hello there, 哈，我是李贝。Back to it, I guess. Back to it. 标准教程六级下册练习册。All right, and we're up to 39. 第39课，听力。I'll start the MP3. All right.
第39课，互联网时代的生活。
互联网时代的生
一、
活，
分立。第一部分，
网络的
第
信
一
息
到五
资源
题，
很
请
有
选出
限，
与昨天内容一致的一项。
互联网
现
充
在
满了
开
我们的
始第
生
一
活，
题。
我们可以通过互
一，
联网环游世界。
不知不觉中，互联网已经进入了我们的生活。我们可以通过互联网得到海量信息，从天文到地理，从深水到太空，从远古到现代，从国内到国外。我们可以通过互联网学习、浏览新闻杂志，获知发生在世界各地的时事要闻。互联网给我们的生活带来了乐趣，使我们的生活变得更加充实。
Oh, no, I was a bit hasty there, wasn't I? She didn't precisely say this. Okay. So he just said that as this last sentence. Okay, 网络的信息资源很有限。No, it's the complete opposite. He said 海量 meaning as like, I don't know, the quantity is as large as the ocean. It's not limited. 互联网充实我们的生活，he said that, so that's the answer. That was like the last sentence. 我们可以通过互联网环游世界。Basically, if he didn't say that, the other words would have meant that. 环游，互联网让我们进入别人的生活。He just didn't say that. All right, 下一个。很多同学玩游戏上瘾。Oh, we're talking about
二，
games。老师脾气
我
好。
们班一大半同学都有手机，虽然每次上课老师都要求我们关掉手机，但关不关就看自己了。很多人都把手机调到震动状态，在桌子下面偷偷玩。很多同学都对发短信上瘾，有同学喜欢自己编写各种短信，下课的时候还比较谁的短信新鲜好玩。
All right, so we're not playing games, we're sending messages in class. Yeah, 上瘾，他们上瘾的不是游戏，就是短信。下课后大家会比较谁的手机好？That's got nothing to do with anything, really. 老师对手机的管理不那么严格。Sort of. She didn't seem especially strict. She had some rules, but not zero rules. 老师脾气好，学生不听话就算了。脾气好，you'd think would be a good thing, right? Whereas this one, 不听话。So in Chinese, 不听话 is disobedient. Yeah, usually would you describe like at a certain age, it's like you don't talk about obedience. It's C or D. What do you think? C? Shall we go C? Are you feeling the C? Oh, and I'm a younger. I'm gonna go C because the students were playing with their like sending messages in class. She had a rule, but lots of the students were breaking it. There you go. 家长和老师担心互联网诈
三，
骗。
作为年轻人，我们上网更多的是消遣和娱乐。有许多同龄人认为，网络这个完全虚拟的世界是我们放松自己的最佳场所。也许正因为这一点，我们的家长和老师才会对学生上网表现出不同程度的抵制，因为他们认为网上的娱乐分散了我们过多的精力，会对学业造成影响。更为重要的是，他们害怕网络上的不良信息对我们的身心不利。
Yeah, distract us, basically. 分或者分散学生的精力。Yeah. Usually they don't just say the answer like that.
钱包不带没关系，手机千万不能忘。人们越来越深刻地感受到，在手机支付已成为重要的支付方式的今天，出门已不必非要手机、钱包、钥匙一样都不能少。互联网之所以能够进入金融业，不是因为互联网天生能做金融，而是因为传统的金融业忽略了网络支付功能。
哦，支付功能。Maybe I was a bit hasty with my decision. I chose B, but I'm looking at A now. 互联网天生适合做金融。天生 usually refers to like a person, right? 天生 kind of inherently or intrinsically is useful for finance. Okay, 出门丢什么都不能丢手机。如今手机支付已十分普遍。手机、钱包、钥匙必须随身带。Yeah, so the discussion was mostly about these things like 钱包 was replaced with your phone. 钥匙 nowadays, yeah. I've lived, the last place I lived, they didn't have keys, they just had 密码. Yeah. 出门 should I go A or should I go B? I'm gonna go A. And put B in bracket. It could be B. I just might be wrong about that. Vega? 众筹 crowdfunding, yeah. 众筹建房会增加融资基本。
与传统的房地产开发模式相比，众筹建房的确大大缓解了房地产企业的销售压力。以往，在开发商的总成本中，融资成本和销售成本分别占比 7% 和 3% 左右。如今，通过互联网设立的融资平台，房企绕过银行获得了新的融资渠道，从而将融资成本大大降低。另一方面，合伙众筹的成员也有机会从中受益，不但房价更合算，并且可以按照自己的需求定制房产，满足个性化需求。
All right, so I kind of got a rough idea what that meant, but we're talking about crowdfunding for 建房, like building a place, and you can use that through, it has a few benefits, or maybe it's not like Kickstarter or something like that. It's more like, oh, you get people to pay and they build certain types of houses or something. Okay. 众筹建房会增加融资成本。增加? It's not 增加, it is 降低, if I remember correctly. 众筹建房的成员可以定期房产。No, 定制房产. Yeah, this one, right? So if you are in like participating in the crowdsourcing of the construction of buildings, you can make demands for how the building is. 房地产企业的众筹建房中很尴尬. I don't know what that's got to do with anything, but all right. 传统房地产开发模式销售压力更小，更小 ，maybe. I don't think he said that though. I think it's B. 来一部分。
第二部分。
哪个部分？
第六到十题，请选出正确答案。
资料和基地。
现在开始第六到十题。
朋友，我都没有朋友。
第六到十题是根据下面一段采访
对话。
您好，您能不能重点跟我们谈谈社交网站给传统交往方式带来了哪些影响？
最近几年，社交网络非常流行， 用户可以在网站创建一个公开或半公开的个人账号，展示和自己有联系的其他用户，查看和搜索与自己有联系的用户以及与朋友有联系的用户，还能交到新朋友，和更多的人建立起联系。
这是人们使用网站的主要目的吗？
还不是。
那人们使用社交网站的主要目的是什么呢？
应该说，社交网站主要体现的还是现实世界中的人际关系。社交网站使我们能够和平时不常见的人保持联系，但是要注意，介绍陌生人给你并不是社交网站的意图。
那现实中的友谊和互联网中的友谊有什么区别呢？
现实中的友谊和互联网上的友谊并不相同。在线联系并不意味着你们交换过电话号码。对于一些联系人，也许你觉得线上交流比线下交流舒服。网上的友谊一般是慢慢积累起来的，人们一般会在网上增加联系，而不会切断联系。而且，我们和朋友在网上的交流方式也不一样。比如，在网上，我们的交流更加简洁，而不是专注的较长时间的对话。
在线上社交网络中，我们不仅维护着和所有朋友的珍贵友情，还能看到他们和其他人的交往和互动，这一点比在现实生活中要容易得多。
确实，有时候你的线上好友传上一组照片，你会发现他们刚和你去了同一个国家，突然之间你和好友的距离一下子就拉近了，对好友的日常生活一下就有了了解。也许你还会发现和你线上好友互动的人中也有你的朋友，而你之前并不知道他们认识，这对于你也许是一份惊喜。
六，人们在社交网站上可以做什么？
So talking about social media, and its impact on friendships and difference between online and offline friendships. 炫耀和自己有联系的朋友，查看其他网络用户的账号，通过朋友交到更多的朋友，建立自己公开或半公开的账号。Is it A B or D? I don't know. I'm gonna put D. I'm not good at this one. I don't know why. 下一个，迅速扩大朋友的范围，和更多的陌生人成为朋友，和不宜见面。
使用线上社交网站的主要目的是什么？
主要目的，主要目的和不宜见面的朋友保持联系。Could be that one. 与失联的朋友 ，No, nothing to do with that. Caught up. I think it's C.C is the closest to my recollection. All right, 下一个。交流更加简洁，联系更加频繁，对话更加专注。
与网上交流方式相比，线下交流的特点是什么？
Maybe it is C. 对话时间更短。No, I think it's C. All right, 下一个。交流起来更加任性，不想联系了你自然断交。
九，互联网中的友谊有什么特点？
友谊 friendships, 互联网的友谊有什么特点？So online friendships, 都不要对方的电话号码。建立友谊，尤其靠日积月累。I think it's B. I don't know. The others don't seem remotely familiar.看到朋友传上的照片 could be that one 啊，和朋友一块儿去。
根据对话，什么情况下我们会有惊喜？
Yeah, we see friends' photos, and it's like, oh, okay, that's right, we're from the same country or something like this. 去朋友一块儿去旅游，和朋友一块儿去，发现和朋友住得很近，发现和朋友有共同的朋友。It was just seeing the photos and it's like, yeah, that was a big 惊喜. So that's A, right? Alright, 下一个，下一个部分。Alright, 适应所有的环境。
第三部分，第十一到十七题，
计算速度，
请选出正确答案。
肯定会有，肯定不会。
现在开始第十一到十三题。第十一到十三题是根据下面一段话。
Invention？ 嗯。
电脑和人脑尽管在传送信息方式上表现不同，但两者在诸多功能上非常类似。
Okay.
比如电脑和人脑都可以存储记忆，电脑和人脑都可以通过修正执行新的任务，电脑和人脑都有探知所处周围环境的能力，并据此做出反应，进行调整并适应所在的环境。电脑与人脑的最大区别在于意识，尽管我们很难描述意识，但却知道它的存在。电脑没有意识，尽管它具有惊人的运算速度，但却无法体验情绪、梦想和思维。而情绪、梦想和思维却是我们之所以成为人类的必备元素。是否会有像人一样思考和行动的机器出现呢？目前没有肯定的答案。不过，科学家对人脑和电脑的研究正在缩小它们之间的差距。
Alright, we're comparing brains and computers.
电脑与人脑的相似之处是什么？
How do they think differently? It was this one, 意识, wasn't it? 适应所有的环境。Your brain adapts to all environments. Not so sure about 所有的。注意王室的能力。探知未知的潜能。改变环境的愿望。Is it this one? So, 探知未知的。I don't know. 注意王室的能力。Maybe it is A. No, I just don't know. I'm going to choose A.I can't exclude them. If I can't get it right, I'd like to get it down to two options. But here, I can't even do that. None of them seem even remotely familiar. That's the difference. So this is going to be A, right? 记存储的多少。They mentioned that, but not the quantity.
电脑与人脑的最大区别是什么？
最大区别就是A，就是A。意识。
十三，是否会有像人一样思考和行动的机器出现呢？
Yeah, we don't know yet. 出现了，目前没有肯定的答案。Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the answer. Whatever the question is.
第十四到十七题是根据下面一段话。
Alright, 价格。
有人出门旅行，或者到一个新城市工作亦或生活，都会选择通过网络寻找住房。通过网络寻找住房不仅快捷方便，还有很多意想不到的惊喜。某租房平台最近就投入500万启动了一项用户补贴行动。租房平台将以发放优惠券的形式给租客报销未来12个月的房租。租客最高享受补贴可达2400元。 同时还对房东承诺24小时闪电出租，并有大额房屋财产保险赠送。租房平台创始人小王说，互联网租房行业并不需要纯信息服务的中介，事实上有超过一半的租房交易都是房东和房客直接接触完成的。对于租客，租房平台承诺提供全程随时联络，100%个人房源。对于房东，租房平台提供的租客身份审查、按时缴纳房租都是最受欢迎的服务。最快的租赁速度，最低的交易成本，最高的交易效率，最好的租房体验，更具品质的租住生活，快速与安全，这才是核心目标。而这一切的实现都将得益于网络的发展。
14，根据本文，网络租房最大的好处是什么？
Yeah, so we're talking about renting places on the internet. Yeah, I don't know, it seemed to... What's the word? that's a coupon or a voucher or something. 快捷方便，价格适中。I think it's just B. I said this, but that was kind of a sideline, I think. The most important fact was it's very convenient to rent places online. Okay, 房屋平台有保险相送，有机会中500万大奖。
15，根据本文，房东在某租房平台能得到什么惊喜？
平台多给一年的房租，可享受国家给的补贴。I don't know, I don't know. Is it A? None of them seem especially, like, directly related to what was said, but I think A was the closest. 提供海量租房信息，保证100%个人房源。
16，
为租
对于房东，租房平台最受欢迎的服务是什么？
最受欢迎的服务为租住双方节省时间，确保租客身份的真实性。房源，个人房源。I guess it's C.Just saves a lot of time, a lot of effort for landlords or whatever renting their places. 网上支付房租，筛选出优惠房源，为租赁双方保密，做到。
关于网络租房的核心目标，
核心目标
下列哪项正确？
在核心目标 like core goals, 网上支付房租。为租赁双方保密。This isn't like, not really a core goal, right? 做到既快速又安全。Yeah, it'll be D. Fast and safe. Alright. Now we do take two. These were my answers.
互联网时代的生活。
And I switched a green pen to correct them.
第一部分
If I need to correct them,
第一到五题，请选出与所听内容一致的一项。
Here I chose B.
现在开始第一题。
也充实了我们的生活。
不知不觉中，互联网已经进入了我们的生活。我们可以通过互联网得到海量信息，从天文到地理，从深水到太空，从远古到现代，从国内到国外。我们可以通过互联网学习、浏览新闻杂志，获知发生在世界各地的时事要闻。互联网给我们的生活带来了乐趣， 使我们的生活变得更加充实。
更加充实 ，Yeah. Alright. Definitely that one. Here I chose C. 老师对手机的管理不那么严格。Not too strict about the phone.
我们班一大半同学都有手机，虽然每次上课老师都要求我们关掉手机。
Yeah, 虽然，
但关不关就看自己了。
Yeah.
很多人都把手机调到震动状态，在桌子下面偷偷玩。很多同学都对发短信上瘾，有同学喜欢自己编写各种短信，下课的时候还比较谁的短信新鲜好玩。
Yeah, I think C is a reasonable one. Here I chose D. Yeah, 分散学生的精力。I think the audio literally just said that, right?
三。
作为年轻人，我们上网更多的是消遣和娱乐。有许多同龄人认为，网络这个完全虚拟的世界是我们放松自己的最佳场所。也许正因为这一点，我们的家长和老师才会对学生上网表现出不同程度的抵制，因为他们认为网上的娱乐分散了我们过多的精力，会对学业造成影响。更为重要的是，他们害怕网络上的不良信息对我们的身心不利。
我们身心不利，Okay, here I chose A. I said it could be B. 互联网天生适合做金融。
钱包不带没关系，手机千万不能忘。人们越来越深刻地感受到，在手机支付已成为重要的支付方式的今天，出门已不必非要手机、钱包、钥匙一样都不能少。互联网之所以能够进入金融业，不是因为互联网天生能做，
不是，
而是因为传统的金融业忽略了网络支付功能。
Right, definitely be. 嗯。Alright, here I chose B. 成员可以定制房产。
与传统的房地产开发模式相比，众筹建房的确大大缓解了房地产企业的销售压力。以往，在开发商的总成本中，融资成本和销售成本分别占比 7% 和 3% 左右。如今，通过互联网设立的融资平台，房企绕过银行获得了新的融资渠道，从而将融资成本大大降低。另一方面，合伙众筹的成员也有机会从中受益，不但房价更合算，并且可以按照自己的需求定制房产，
定制
满足个性化需求。
Yeah, alright. So the next, yeah, I only changed one there, so that's alright. They seem pretty solid.
第二部分，第六到十题。请选出正确的。
So for the interview, I chose
B, C, B, A. 现在开始第六到十题。第六到十题是根据下面一段采访。
B, C, B, A.
您好，您能不能重点跟我们谈谈社交网站给传统交往方式带来了哪些影响？
最近几年，社交网络非常流行，用户可以在网站创建一个公开或半公开的个人账号，展示和自己有联系的其他用户，查看和搜索与自己有联系的用户以及与朋友有联系的用户，还能交到新朋友，和更多的人建立起联系。
这是人们使用网站的主要目的吗？
还不是。
那人们使用社交网站的主要目的是什么呢？
主要目的
应该说，社交网站主要体现的还是现实世界中的人际关系。社交网站使我们能够和平时不常见的人保持联系，但是要注意，介绍陌生人给你并不是社交网站的意图。
那现实中的友谊和互联网中的友谊有什么区别呢？
现实中的友谊和互联网上的友谊并不相同。在线联系并不意味着你们交换过电话号码。对于一些联系人，也许你觉得线上交流比线下交流舒服。网上的友谊一般是慢慢积累起来的，人们一般会在网上增加联系，而不会切断联系。而且我们和朋友在网上的交流方式也不一样，比如在网上，我们的交流更加简洁，而不是专注的较长时间的对话。
在线上社交网络中，我们不仅维护着和所有朋友的珍贵友情，还能看到他们和其他人的交往和互动，这一点比在现实生活中要容易得多。
确实，有时候你的线上好友传上一组照片，你会发现他们刚和你去了同一个国家，突然之间你和好友的距离一下子就拉近了，对好友的日常生活一下就有了了解。也许你还会发现和你线上好友互动的人中也有你的朋友，而你之前并不知道他们认识，这对于你也许是一份惊喜。
六，人们在社交网站上可以做什么？
Yeah, I think it's D. It's a very strange answer, right? You'd expect something profound. What can you do online? You can start an account. This sort of thing. It's a bit weird. Anyway.
人们使用线上社交网站的主要目的是什么？
So why do people want online friendships? 迅速扩大朋友的范围，和更多的陌生人成为朋友，和不已见面的朋友保持联系。That's what I chose. I think it's the closest. 与已失联的朋友重新建立关系。So I think I chose the best. I'll leave it alone. Here I chose C. 对话更加专注。
八，与网上交流方式相比，线下交流的特点是什么？
线下 ，that's offline, like face-to-face communication. 交流更加简洁。Oh, maybe it's that. 简洁 meaning, if it's 简单 ，OK, 联系更加频繁。That's got nothing in it. So I think it's 对话时间更短。I think it's A or C. What do you think? Let's just do that. 不想联系了就自然断交 ，not perfect。
九，互联网中的友谊有什么特点
？The friendship kind of just disappears if you don't keep in contact。交流起来更加任性。任性 is like headstrong. I don't know what the relevance is for that this word。都不要对方的电话号码，不要。都不要。It could be that one, eh? 建立友谊，尤其靠日累月积，日积月累。累。Could it be this one? 都不要。So, if you interpret the 要 as 不需要, you don't need it, 不用, well, that sort of thing. This one's not great. So they did mention it.You don't really just sever contact. You just gradually lose contact, right? So let's change 9 to C. But maybe it's B. All right. And so I chose A. That one's definitely A. 说话
是。根据对话，什么情况下我们会有惊喜
？Yeah, they talked about. They talked about. Yeah, you see someone online. Oh, we're in the same country. From your
第三部分，第十一到十七题，请选出正确答案。
Here I chose A A C. I wasn't confident with the first one.
第十一到十三题。
What was the topic? Oh, different. Computers versus human brains. Alright.
电脑和人脑尽管在传送信息方式上表现不同，但两者在诸多功能上非常类似。比如，电脑和人脑都可以存储记忆，电脑和人脑都可以通过修正执行新的任务，电脑和人脑都有探知所处周围环境的能力。 并据此做出反应，进行调整并适应所在的环境。
调整适应环境。
电脑与人脑的最大区别在于意识，尽管我们很难描述意识，但却知道它的存在。电脑没有意识，尽管它具有惊人的运算速度，但却无法体验情绪、梦想和思维。而情绪、梦想和思维却是我们之所以成为人类的必备元素。是否会有像人一样思考和行动的机器出现呢？目前没有肯定的答案。不过，科学家对人脑和电脑的研究正在缩小它们之间的差距。
十一，电脑与人脑的相似之处是什么？
相似之处。They adapt to environments. It's A. All right. Here I chose A. And absolutely.
十二，电脑与人脑的最大区别是什么？
Here it's like awareness or consciousness. It's just this kind of attribute humans ascribe to their own intelligence. Aha, you don't have that.
是否会有像人一样思考和行动的机器出现呢？
Yeah. All right. So for the last four, I chose B, A, C, D. I was unsure about this one. B. Yeah. 快点方便。
第十四到十七题
yeah, not
是根据下面一段话。
But we'll see.
有人出门旅行。或者到一个新城市工作亦或生活，都会选择通过网络寻找住房。通过网络寻找住房不仅快捷方便，还有很多意想不到的惊喜。某租房平台最近就投入500万启动了一项用户补贴行动。租房平台将以发放优惠券的形式给租客报销未来12个月的房租。租客最高享受补贴可达2400元，同时还对房东承诺24小时闪电出租，并有大额房屋财产保险赠送。租房平台创始人小王说，互联网租房行业并不需要纯信息服务的中介，事实上有超过一半的租房交易都是房东和房客直接接触完成的。对于租客，租房平台承诺提供全程随时联络，100%个人房源。对于房东，租房平台提供的租客身份审查、按时缴纳房租都是最受欢迎的服务。最快的租赁速度、最低的交易成本、最高的交易效率、最好的租房体验、更具品质的租住生活、快速与安全，这才是核心目标。而这一切的实现都将得益于网络的发展。
十四，根据本文，网络租房最大的好处是什么？
This one. I think that's the best one. It's just so convenient. Here I chose A. I'm still not 100% sure. 邮递会中，
根据本文，房东在某租房平台。能得到什么惊喜
？OK， 有机会中500万大奖。I don't think so 。平台多给一年的房租。I don't know. They said something like Shark Year. It was some sort of 补贴，可享受国家给的补贴。I honestly don't know.A seems to be the closest to what I heard. I don't know if what I heard was relevant to that question. So I'll leave it alone. I chose C here, but I'm still not sure. 提供海量租房信息。
对于房东，租房平台最受欢迎的服务是什么？
Just this one, right? 保证百分之。Yeah.Alright, I think that's fine. Here, yeah, 做到既快速又安全。
关于网络租房的核心目标，下列哪项正确？
Yeah, alright, let's continue on. Now for the reading section. So, 语病, let's find some grammar errors. 每个人都把这些樱花树看是中日友好的象征。Okay, 中 is China, 日 is Japan. 把这个看是 is it 看是看为 I think 看是 is okay. 与会代表还听取了第四届乒乓球赛筹备情况的报告。听取报告。还听取了。听取报告。Not so sure about 听取报告。All right. 我们要以最大的努力去落实政策。一直到问题解决为止。Yeah, that's fine. 他有时无意中买到一本喜欢的书。回家后简直爱不释手。无意中。Alright, 简直爱不释手。I think it's fine. So, did I see anything weird? The only weird thing was 听取报告。听取。So, usually, when you use 听取, you acquire some information rather than 听取报告, you 听取报告内的信息。Was there anything else that's weird? I mean, I can't definitively say that that's wrong. Yeah, maybe it's like 从报告里,从这个里,听取了重要的信息。I didn't see any others. 都把,每个人都把这些樱花树,看是,这个就是, I think 看是 is okay. So I'm going to choose B with the 听取. That's my theory. That I think the 听取 is weird.I just didn't see anything especially egregious or outrageous, so I'll just choose B. Yeah, the only two things I think are weird is a can shu and then can wei or shu wei. I think that's okay. 听取, usually 听取报告. Alright, 下一个。我很不懂浪漫，很不懂。So when you can use 不很懂, no. So with adjectives, you can use 很不漂亮 and 不很漂亮. But with a verb, can you say 很不懂? 我很不习惯。那我不很习惯,我不太习惯。That's a bit sus. 他很不懂浪漫。对妻子连一句也没说体贴的话，也没说连一句也。This is wrong, isn't it? So, 连一句体贴的话也没说。Yeah, that's wrong. The word order is wrong. 一句。体贴的话也没说。It has to be that. I don't think you can put it in this order. Yeah, I think that's the error. 很不懂浪漫。That's also a bit suspicious. I think I've already chosen A. If it was the actual exam, I'd just choose A and move on to the next question because you just don't have time. 第二口也借口情况变化而全盘否定历史。What are we talking about? 抛弃传统是错误的。借口。Are you sure this is the right word? 借口 is to make excuses. 借口情况变化而全盘 否定历史。I guess 全盘 means 全部。Ah, so on the, using the excuse of situations changing and thoroughly denying history and abandoning tradition is mistaken. Yeah, all right, I guess that's okay. 深夜，两名不法分子，冒充公安局，公安人民将这个人，寄存的包骗走了。All right. 一个年轻人饮酒后，仗着酒势。I don't know what that means. 酒劲，酒劲，仗着酒劲。What does that mean? Is that getting into a scuffle or something? 警工人在马路上持刀追逐行人。Yeah. Grammatical, I think. Yeah, I think absolutely that's the answer. The word order is incorrect there. Okay. 波尔顿当时在新奥尔良的乐师中有国王之称。这个What does that mean? 乐师中 So this is, will be like within music teachers. So he's the king of music teachers or something like this. 由他组建的乐队很快就家喻户晓。家喻户晓。Can 家喻户晓 be used as a verb? 变得家喻户晓。I don't think it can be used as a verb, right?That's a bit suspicious, but let's continue. 那个人对记者说公主病了，因此今天不能开招待会了，等公主治好病才安排吧。 Yeah, that's correct. Interesting sentence. 这次的谈话变成兴奋极了，虽然大部分是老骚话 ，OK， 但他说的都极其风趣。风趣 is a noun, is it? 极其，that's a bit suspicious as well. 使我们笑得合不拢嘴 ，like is this like can't shut your mouth? Okay, I'm not sure about that. 公司实行股份制后，原来的企业职工多数将成为股东。
So these people, the workers are becoming shareholders.
对形成员工与企业命运共同。共同体极为有利，
极为有利 ，That's correct, right?
同时便于企业吸收社会资金用于生产。
Word order is not correct here, right?
便于企业吸收社会资金用于生产。
Maybe if there's like an invisible comma here or something.
对这个有利，同时便于。
Hold on. So where's the verb? So this is the subject, the 员工. They did this.
对形成职工与企业命运共同体极为有利。
Okay, so 他们对这个极为有利，
同时便于，也他们对这个便于，也这个用于生产， I think there's an issue with the subject here, right? Do you see an issue with the subject? Alright. Anyway, so there was three candidates, Jiayu Hu Xiao Le. Now, Jiayu Hu Xiao, I believe, is an adjective. In Chinese, a lot of adjectives can function as verbs, meaning to become more like that adjective. 很快就叫有呼啸. I think I can accept that line of reasoning. Here, 极其风趣. Is that an adjective or is it a noun? 风趣 sounds like a noun to me. So 极其风趣 wouldn't make sense. 都极其风趣. If you say 极其有趣. That one's a bit suspicious. This seems like 变语. So what is the subject for 变语 here? Yeah, I think that's the error. It's not clear what the subject is for 变语. 变语企业吸收社会资金用于生产. So, what's this? Whatever, I guess it's this change. The change facilitates enterprise, extracting societal money and using it for production. But this should be the subject. No, maybe we can interpret this change as the subject. Yeah, if you interpret it like that, then I think that's okay. So let's go see. Alright, so I think 极其风趣 is a bit weird. I'm not 100% sure on that one. That one's quite hard. Alright. Yeah. The reading section the last time was quite hard, I found. Yeah, there's a lot more text, isn't there? I'm not going mad, right? If we flick back to an earlier chapter. Yeah, it's much shorter. And in here, it's long. All right. But more importantly, do we know the words? Right. 网页游戏发展时中不得不提偷菜游戏具有明显的游戏特点什么什么互动互助注意追求 So that was like what 10-15 years ago now, there was a program, a game called, Kaixin Nongchang. And only Chinese people were like waking up first thing in the morning to steal their friends' vegetables. Alright, sorry, I'm gonna go to the bathroom for a second. Alright, where are we? Oh yeah, we're here, yeah. 什么什么互动互助. Oh, I forgot to turn the light off, sorry, one second. Yeah, so I didn't want to waste electricity, but I probably use more electricity. Or let's not analyze this. Who don't hold up? So 追求, maybe 追求, 希望, maybe. 讲究 is a bit weird. Anyway, 好友, 越多越有趣. Yeah, 有趣. Adjective, not 风趣. 每天用户只需要上线给自己或者帮朋友的作物浇浇水杀杀虫除除草收收果实 Well, all right. Okay, 即使 is like immediately, right? So I don't think you can use it like that. So we'll get rid of 即使. 就可, 即便, 即便. 即便, this is a conjunction, right? Meaning even if. 即便 is equivalent to 即使. I do not think you can put it there. 即可就可, it could be, I just don't know those two. So maybe. 即可. 即 is often used to mean something like i.e. So maybe this is okay. 如果有损友来玩家农场里 学坏或者盗取果实，农场的狗也可以抓住它。该游戏不仅可以什么什么用户上线的积极性。 So, alright. 还可以, okay, so 不仅可以这个，还可以促使 用户发起与站内友好友的互动. All right, so your积极性, so you're like 调动 is a good choice. 调动, you're kind of motivating or prompting their 积极性. That's a good choice. 讲究. Maybe. I don't know what 即可 means, really. 变动. Well, we got rid of that with 即便 already, right? 变动. What, I'm not too sure what that means. 变, change, 动, move, 变动. Not sure. Is that a physics term? 调节. 调节 is regulate. It's not relevant to 积极性. It, well, in this context, if you were talking about, like, I don't know, I'm regulating your emotions in a psychological interview or something, maybe. 发动. 发动 is launch. I don't think you can launch positivity. So I think that only leaves D as a possibility. Yeah, come on, that's hard. There's all these words I don't know. They're not HSK words. 人们在大规模数据的基础上可以做到的事情，在小规模数据的基础上是无法完成的。全球新产生数据年增 40%， 即新气总量每两年就可以翻番。 So it doubles every 4 years, every 2 years, okay? 而且, 这个趋势还在什么什么增加? Oh no, it'd be 加速, accelerating. So this speed is accelerating. 加速. No, it's 加速. That's the best choice. 什么什么能够更有效的组织和使用大数据? 若,
so if, it's basically just if.
如果, the others don't really make sense. 假若, 若干, numerous. 若非, alright, it's surely it's A, right?
人类将得到更多的机会发挥, 更多的机会发挥数据对社会发展的巨大推动作用。
Oh yeah, you 发挥作用. That's a collocation. 发挥作用.
研究证明通过大数据和
What is that character? 明率分布分析 人类行为 93% 是可以预测的。Yeah, you can predict people's behavior. 成为已经发生的未来。已经发生的未来。All right. Because they have so much data on you, they can predict what you're going to do next. You can probably predict what I'm going to do next. I'm going to go on to question 23. Probably the more interesting in my purchasing decisions. You can go downstairs and sell figs. I buy figs. I have some figs in my fridge. It's fig season. 无花果。近些年全球兴起金融there must be 创新 right? Innovation. Financial innovation. 创新 that is a person, is it not? 创新 like a pioneer of some kind. 创造创造 is a verb, so I don't think, for the, in the sentence, the 兴起 is the verb, right? So I don't think you can use 创造. 创造, can you use it as creation or something like that? 开创, that's also a verb. So I think it must be 创新 innovation. 在中国,移动金融,投资和贷款似乎成了主流，在手机客户端的帮助下，在这个有着13亿人口和7.8 万亿美元的市场里，什么什么科技公司正在向银行等传统机构发起什么什么okay, so we have two in one here. 什么什么科技公司众多当众当众 in front of the public? No, not real. That's completely out of it. That's like crazy. 多数 is fine. 众多 is fine. 广大广大 I think is also okay, but it refers to a different concept with 广大 is major tech companies. So there could be few. Kind of a better choice as well, right?It's like Google is a major tech company as opposed to many minor tech companies. Okay. 传统发起攻击 yeah, launch an attack. 战斗挑战斗争 No, it's definitely A. 提醒危机在中国注册手机银行业务的有3.9亿人，这超过了美国总人口。什么什么？全球手机银行客户的40%。Way is not correct. It needs to be 占。It's 占。Oh, no, 占 is the best. So, oh, sorry, I said 创新 is the best here.So, 创新 is best. Okay, so 广大 Maybe you can't say 广大科技公司 Okay, 发起挑战 I can accept. 发起攻击 is good. Anyway, it's B. 战 Alright. That's a house with a paper. Oh, we're doing a 3D modeling.It's English. 忽如一夜春风来，千树万树梨花开。So if there is a breeze of spring, like 10,000 plum trees, no, pear trees blossom. 似乎在一夜之间，什么什么什么什么，一夜之间。Whoa, 3D printing, here we go.Could be A, 已经被运 It could be C. It can't be this one. This is a question. So that's going to be there, right? All right. 3D 打印成了每个科技媒体乃至大众时尚媒体争相报道的热门话题。 Yeah, that's a good choice. 3D 打印已经被运用到各个行业中。So this one's better because we're about to talk about where it's discussed. 在环球科技杂志2013年评选出的2012年最值得铭记对人类社会产生影响最为深远的十大新闻中 3D 打印位列第九什么什么什么他就开始 No 理由是 3D 打印将在制造业和科研领域引发一场革命。It could be that. I'm not sure. Anyway, the first gap, I think, is an A. Yeah, these have gotten much harder. 3D 打印真的会给制造业带来革命性的变化吗? Oh no, that's a question. So 27 is E, regardless of anything else. All right. Here, yeah, 理由是. So this 25 could be D or B, right? So it's not obvious. I think we have to get back to that one.Sometimes, yeah, you have to go back to them. 与此同时 ,3D 打印技术在全球的推广也正在以惊人的速度增长。房子、足球鞋、手枪、鼓楼，对对对。然后 ,okay, we have this ellipsis. Oh, hold on. We have the ellipsis. We got this. 将原本难以实现的设想一一转化成现实。So we need a subject that is 3D printing. This one? That makes sense. C makes sense. In 26. And...全球 3D 打印机制造巨头之一的美国 3D Systems 公司负责全球市场营销的副总裁凯西刘易斯曾自信满满的说有了 3D 打印一切不再复杂。3D 打印机几乎可以创造任何东西。Sort of. Can it make water? 在企业、科研机构和媒体的互动下 ,3D 打印的未来似乎一片光明甚至频频被提到或将带来第三次工业革命的高度。All right, and then the question. 3D 打印真的会给制造业带来革命性的变化吗? I think so. It is a pretty impressive technology. It's not complete, it can't do literally everything, but it's pretty impressive. 其实 ,3D 打印背后的艺术并不新鲜。早在一二十年前，一二，什么什么，他就开始以这个 ，Yeah, that's a good choice. B for 28. So what's left? D for 24. Yeah, I said that was a good choice as well. B， 他就开始以快速成型技术。这一名称应用于汽车、航空、航天模型设计中。为何在出现多年后才突破燃起 3D 打印的关系热桥？ 3D 打印正在改变什么，未来还能改变什么，仅仅是一次概念热潮，还是真的将带来一场生产方式变革。我们不再 care 的，拭目以待。This is to wipe your tears away or something. All right. Anyway, let's continue. I think my answers there are okay. Well, obviously, if I thought they were bad, I would change them. All right. How's that? We have half brain, half gear, half head, half gear. 你是不是一直梦想着有另一个自己？So in your dream, do you have someone else in your dreams? Maybe, I don't know. Well, go ask. When I wake up, almost always I don't have dreams. I just sleep.
双胞胎机器人在赖床的时候可以派他去上学。日本的机器人技术专家石黑浩一直在做这方面的研究，他制造了很多机器人，其中就有一个他自己。他自己 is the 机器人 or him? I'm not sure.
Ambiguous. If I write that, I would lose marks, right?
这位也与石黑浩有着相同面孔的中年男士。
So, Nanshu is in quotes, so that would imply that's the robot. So, a male robot who looks very similar to this Japanese guy.
坦白地说是有橡胶
Yeah, it looks like rubber. That's what it was like. It's improving technology, but it takes time, especially the more physical aspects. The materials science and so on.
气压装置，电子元件构成的。不过这位男士有一个身体组织，组成成分的石黑浩相同，就是头发。这是从他本人头皮上取得的。机器人因为是固定的，所以不能走出实验室去买东西。
Wait, what was 固定的？
因为是固定的。
I don't know, 固定。
Fixed. All right, let's continue. 不过他已经能够初步完成一些任务，就是模仿一个人。
All right.
石黑浩坐在计算机前，远程控制他的机器人，一个麦克风用来捕捉他的声音，一台摄像机跟踪他的脸部和头部运动。当石黑浩说话时，机器人也跟着他做一样的动作，他也会眨眼，抽动。
What is 抽动？ Is it like flinch, a flinch or something like this? Maybe or fidget? I don't know.
表现得像是在呼吸。不过人类的一些行为也被刻意的抑制的。抑制了。当石黑浩点起一根香烟时，机器人就不会继续模仿。石黑浩认为机器双胞胎，是他的好助手。我研究的问题是了解什么是人。我使用非常像人类的机器人来测试我的假设，比如人性、智能和行为。
他的研究领域是人机互动。So he didn't just make a robot, he made a robot of himself, right? 学黑号是什么方面的专家？什么方面？ I guess he's into robotics, right? Like if you manufacture a robot, I presume you're some specialist, 机器人技术专家。I feel like you can only make robots if you're a robot specialist. Your average Joe is not going to come around and make a robot. 机器人学黑号哪一部分跟学黑号本人相同？皮肤、衣着、头发、思想。头发 I don't know. Maybe 衣着啊，衣着 makes sense. 有有，就是头发 ，no, it's 头发。The hair was the same. How's that? Well, did he just like shave off his hair and put it in the robot? All right. 机器人会模仿学黑号。的什么动作 So it was like so, certain behaviors and twitching, blinking. I think this is kind of twitching or something like that. It was quite realistic. 出去买东西 No, 眨眼睛这个 All right, so it's literally the same characters as in the text. 走路说话点起根烟 No, it's a, these sort of subtle behaviors that you don't really notice.学黑号希望利用机器人 so it was this one for mutual help 也代替自己做研究分析人体的 运动测试自己的假设 oh yeah that one too test his hypothesis alright 下一个What is this? This is like a virtual reality, is it? 近年来在广阔的网络文化里一批新兴网媒迅速崛起成为新媒体的亮点。不仅如此在网络社交发展的基础上新型专业社交网站不断涌现。去年社交网站用户和访问量激增吸引了诸多商业巨头纷纷进军社区进军社会网站。
进军 means enter the army, presumably it's join the army, presumably it's figurative here. Anyway, I'm talking about,Like all these kind of digital companies, really. Social media companies.
有专家指出，随着互联网的社交功能日益发展，诸多网络应用已经成为人们进行交往的主要渠道。网络社交用户经过多年积累以成相当规模，这是社交网络热的 ，yeah. So social media hotness, like this trend, right? 的必然条件。
So just getting lots and lots of subscribers and so on.
All right. 社会学家则认为通过社交网站。商业公司不但可以收集手机号、用户号码、用户账号等普通信息，还可以通过分析网民发布的博客、帖子、同学群体等。推测出用户的消费倾向节省还是奢侈个 人婚姻情况，单身还是离婚。I'm assuming there are other options. You're either single or divorced. 工作情况是否有跳槽的意向 ？Job hopping. 等十分文词 ，no 隐私的信息 ，yeah collecting personal information. 社交网站的诸多争议，吸引了大众的眼球。其新奇的社交功能吸引着用户，其病毒式的营销手段 I talked about that last time. 手段 is usually used for something negative. 以及恶意竞争令人惊诧，甚至让人心生生恐惧。新媒体是把双刃剑，它在促进国家经济社会等方面发展的同时，也给经济政治文化社会发展和国家安全军事安全等诸方面带来严重甚至严峻的挑战。从一定意义上讲，谁掌握新媒体，谁就将掌握世界。面对这些严峻挑战，我们不能等闲视之。
Is that like sit around and find out kind of thing? That's what it is. I mean, like.Literally creating databases on everyone in the world is probably quite technically feasible, especially by these major companies, especially if you can go and purchase it. And if you just don't tell people you have this data, then, you know, I think you have to assume everyone in the world has their own profile. Like, these companies are just adding more and more data about you. And if they don't tell people about it, or they just keep it secret, they can use the data, but just keep it secret. And that's really how it feels.
关于今年的网络发展，下列哪项正确？网络自媒体，如雨后春笋，雨后春笋那个
，it'd be like.I think this is more like, it does sprout up everywhere, but you need some kind of 雨后, right?
网上购物, we didn't talk about shopping. 网上购物已经蔚然成风。社交媒体, 社交网站, 用户大量增加, that one. 独特的网络, 网络文化已经形成, this one.
Yeah, it's like, they've talked about it for a long time here, right? Wherever it was. Just large numbers of, I don't know, users. Anyway, it's B. Well, I think it's B. That's why I'm choosing B.
对于网络发展专家的观点是社交网络热不会持久。
No!
互联网的社交功能仍有有待发展。
No, 有待发展 still waiting for development, no.
网络是现今人们进行交往的主要途径。
Might be true, but that's not what they said.
网络已无法承载日益增加的网络社交用户。
无法 They're not talking about illegal. So is it this one then? Okay, like a communication channel. Maybe it got mentioned here somewhere.
人们进行交往的主要渠道。
Ah, yeah, there it is. I was a bit hasty.
See. 对于网络发展现状，社会学家认为，手机号成了收藏品，网络病毒， we didn't talk about it. 不危害不浅。个人隐私易被泄露 ，maybe that one。人们对网络爱恨交加。Or could be this one. The main thing they talk about is personal information being leaked. Well, they didn't say leaked, so did they? Yeah, they talked for quite a while about personal information. Did they use the word leak or just known to others or gathered? 收集 yeah, 收集 Yeah, I have to choose B. Alright, 最后一段中新媒体是把双刃剑是指新媒体双刃剑 double-edged sword. It's the same in English. 有利有弊 Oh, there it is. 在快速发展祸不单行 I don't know what that means. 在挑战传统 No, 有利有弊 There's pros and cons. Alright, give me answers. We switch to the red pen.And we find the official answers. 39. There's only 40 in this book, so we're nearly done. 39 is the official answers. Let's see how I did. B, C, D, C, B. If I don't want more. D, C, C, D, D, O. A, A, C, B, A, D.So I got four wrong in the listening section. That's fine by me. By my standards. Oh, you're a B. You have two of the U Bing sections wrong. New section, U Bing section. A, D, C, B. B, B, C, C, B, C, B, A. So I got six wrong. So by Fin Jidor Shao. I'm just going to cheat and use a calculator. It's more reliable. So that's fine. That's sort of, if I actually got that kind of mark on the exam, I'd be thrilled. If I got 70% on the actual exam, I would be happy with that and probably just go, yep, I'm never doing this exam again. I will move on with life. But anything, yeah, if it's too low, the marks, I'll probably have to rethink. Anyway, four I got wrong. So four...I chose A, said it could be B, then I changed it to B, well, C. Okay, so let us go back. So the answer was C. 如今手机支付已十分普遍。I remember saying that, and that could have been a possibility. I did note that. But how do you exclude A and B? So let's read 4 and see what we learned.
钱包不带没关系，手机千万不能忘。
Yeah， 人们越来越深刻的感受到，在手机支付已成为重要的支付方式的今天，出门已不必非常不必非要手机、钱包、钥匙，也不必非要。都不能少。What does it mean? 出门已不必非要手机、钱包、钥匙一样都不能少。It's a triple negative, is it? 不必非要 negative negative 不能少。I don't know. What does that mean? So confusing.
互联网之所以能够进支付方式的今天，出门已不必非要手机。
Sorry, I misread it.
互联网之所以能够进入金融业，不是因为互联网天生能做金融。
Yeah, so that one you can exclude the finance. So A is gone. Oh yeah, that's why I changed my answer, isn't it?
而是因为传统的金融业
忽略了网络支付功能。So how do we exclude B? 出门丢啊，丢什么都不能丢手。No. So do mean, does it mean leave behind in this context? Or does it mean you lose your phone? Oh, you can lose your wallet, lose your keys. No, that's not a big deal. Like when you're out, maybe that's how I'm supposed to interpret it, which is kind of silly. Do, yeah, do doesn't mean just leave behind at home. If it said 忘什么都不能忘手机, yeah, that's the logic. So it is C. All right, fair enough. I got it wrong. Here, for the interview, I got 9 and 10 wrong. So 9. D. The answer. Sorry, the answer is D. What was the question? I was meant to look at. 互联网中的友谊有什么特点? So online friendships have what kind of 特点? What was the answer? The answer was D, right? It was D. I chose B, the answer said it could be C, but the answer was D. Okay, 立即有意尤其靠日积月累。Really? Sorry, we're on this one. 日积月累。建立友谊，尤其靠。Yeah, I guess so. So if you kind of neglect your friends, you lose your friends, your online friends. Yeah, 积累起来。网上的友谊一般是慢慢积累起来的。Yeah, that's it there, isn't it? Yeah, no, that's the answer. I got it wrong. That's the answer. Then I chose A, the answer was D. 发现和朋友有共同的朋友。No. That one was where they were talking about you have a friend from the same country. You discover they put a photo online. That was the 惊喜, right? 根据对话什么情况下我们会有惊喜。So 朋友, so I have a common friend with a friend. So we all know each other. We don't realize we're all friends. 确实有时候你的线上好友传上一组照片，你会发现他们跟和你去了同一个国家。Yeah, I thought that was it. They went to the same country as you. 突然之间你和好友的距离一下子就拉近了，对好友的日常生活一下就有了了解。也许你会你还会发现和你线上好友互动的人中也有你的朋友，而你之前并不知道他们认识。这对于你也许是一番惊喜。 Okay, so it's here the last little bit. So I chose A. What was wrong with A? 看到朋友传上的照片。 Yeah, is that not a 惊喜? Yeah, that's very finicky. All right, anyway, we're meant to take it from this last bit here. All right.For the reading section, well, the reading section, I only got 2 of the Yubing questions wrong. All the others were correct. All right. Well, that's all right. I can't complain about that, eh? All right. Yeah, I remember these being a little bit hard. Here I chose B, the answer was A. Okay, 每个人都把这些樱花树看是终于有意的象征。So should it be 看为 or 视为? Let's Google it. Oh, that's my channel. Hello, channel. 每个人都把这些樱花树看是 What if I just put that in? Is that enough? That didn't help. Oh, I put 看书 That's why it didn't help. Ist das richtig? Touristen ist das Fotografieren im Museum mit I did German in high school. I've forgotten it all. All right. So, what was the error? So, 都把这些英文看作 So it was that. So there is no 看是 Oh, why did it give me this? So 看是 is not a word. Is that right? 看是 It's just not a word. They just made up a word. Or 看是这样 看是 Yeah, I remember saying that. 看作看为是为 I would probably use 是为 of those options. Or, yeah, 是为 Yeah, so why did I choose? Yeah, I wasn't sure about that. Like, language can be a bit flexible, and sometimes there's like 10 different ways of saying it, and I only know 9 of them. And then I quite often find myself in situations where it's like, am I unfamiliar with this usage, or is it not actually a usage? And that requires quite a lot of practice, years and years of practice. To be able to say, no, that doesn't exist, versus, no, I don't know that, right? All right, yeah, A, this is just the wrong order, right? Did that high native article answer all three? Yeah, so my argument was this was in the wrong order. Oh, this is the correction. 连一句体贴的话, yeah. 没说过。All right. So that was my understanding, and they're in there. Back to front order. Anyway. 等公主治好病再安排。Oh. So what was the error? Here I chose C, the answer was B.
公主病了，因此 Okay, 等公主治好病才安排
Yeah, it's not 才, it is 在 Yeah, I missed that
才
cannot refer to like future hypotheticals, right?
才
Yeah, 在 is the one for future
Yeah, it's 在 I missed that But that is important I'm kind of glad I got that wrong Because now it's like, oh yeah, I should have seen that. And I'm glad I got it wrong here and not on the actual exam.
I like questions where I go, you're right, I should have got that one. And I didn't. And I learned something. I'm quite happy when it's like that. I don't like the annoying traps and all this kind of thing. Anyway, that's it. We didn't do these. Yeah, sorry, no, it's not it. Rewind. I missed 14, 16. 14. So, sorry, I missed some of the listening ones. I got 4 wrong in the listening section. 14. Sorry, one second while I find it. Is this 39? What am I looking at? Oh, that's the past. That's the exam. There's a mock exam in here as well. We should do that. 14. What was the question? The question is: 根据本文，网络租房最大的好处是什么？All right.
And this is what they said. Your and Truman 旅行或者到一个新城市工作，就是洋货生活，alright, whatever that means， 都会选择通过网络寻找住房。通过网络寻找住房不仅快捷便方便。I think surely the most important aspect is its convenience. 还有很多意想不到的惊喜。What was the question? Like, 意想不到的惊喜。最大的好处 is 意想不到的。最大的好处不是 I chose B, right? 14, I chose B.有意外惊喜 No. I mean, I remember thinking about that. I'm like, that's kind of like, no one rents a place, like a hotel or like an apartment or something, thinking, oh, I'm really looking forward to the 意外的惊喜. I'm looking forward to the unexpected 惊喜. People buy...people rent houses and places online because they want the convenience, right? I do not accept that as a correct answer. That is illogical. I do not accept that. If it's 意外, 有意外惊喜, like, that's...If it's 意外, then it's unexpected and unpredictable, right? They're not doing it for surprises. 网络租房最大的好处是什么？意外的惊喜。It's just not logical, right? All right, so let's just check. Did I write it down? Oh, no, the answer is B. Oh, okay. I made a mistake. Do you understand what my mistake was? This one is B. It is correct. I put the D here for correcting this. The D here is correcting this one. All right. It did not make sense. That's why I'm like, no, this does not make sense. It's absolutely B. And B was correct. I'm like, no. All right.I got 16 wrong. Sorry, sometimes I'm a little bit of a goose, and that happens to be one of those times. Okay, 16, I put C, the answer is D. So saving time. So, okay, 确保租客身份是真的。的真实性。All right. And what was the question first? 对于房东。租房平台最受欢迎的服务是什么？ So, confirming that they're a real person. And they don't have to do that. So where did we start talking about 房东？对于房东， right, 租房平台提供的租客身份审查， oh yeah, definitely. And 是缴纳租房都是最受欢迎的服务。Yeah, absolutely. That's the answer. I got it wrong. Absolutely. That's the answer. All right. Now we're done. Thank you for watching. We'll call it a video. Yeah, remember to like, subscribe, do the YouTube-y things, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.